So it's about you approaching.
That's what I'd like to know, in your system, do you kind of indicate that it would be better for the brain, maybe even though you use glucose?
Yeah, my question, my answer was very technical. I'm telling you the 2x2 and 3x3 that maybe you. But was exactly that. But I went deep into the technique of the implementation of the detector and why there is this inefficiency, because they are making the analog sum, and I'm sure that Jerry and when they follow me on this. The answer is could detect more photons and more accurately.
More information.
If we are talking about improvements in general, also in the electronic parts of it today, the prototype you build is based on FPGA with certain level of obviously efficiency and better results and power dissipation, so on and so forth. As you envision going into more, commercial type of build and so on, you envision going, I assume, to some more custom build type of ICs. By doing that, what level of improvement do you see in terms of power dissipation, overall electronic capabilities and costing input? Mm.
I have a slide on the backup that maybe now, if the people will get those slides on the web, they can look at that. And the answer is, from the point of view of cost, my estimate, based on the experience that I have, is that with the hard copy, that is the version that is still providing flexibility or changing the algorithm in the program of the processor, but freezing, making a hard copy of the circuit, roughly is $22 to $26 per processor. Then the other estimate is with the 0.18 micron technology, application specific integrated circuit should be around $3 to $4. And with the 0.12, about $1. That is cost point of view. You get also other benefits, that is the die shrinks, the power consumption reduces, the speed increases. So at that point, one can run more and more complex algorithm in filtering, in taking more oblique photons. Now we can limit the oblique photons at 30 degrees, and then you can take up to 45 degrees or something like that. So the slides, what it shows is the goal with the hard copy is to get a bandwidth of the input of the entire system of 10 giga event per second, and for the other one is 36. So high bandwidth, you know that the photons don't come regularly every 50 nanoseconds. They come one and then one after, one nanosecond after, and then stay for a microsecond without getting an electron. So the higher bandwidth you have, the more chance. Obviously, there is a limit. The limit is the saturation or the dead time of the detector. Okay. That is also a limit. On the detector LSO, you get a faster signal, 40 nanoseconds, so you have less dead time on the detector. It pays to put a more sophisticated electronics, like ASIC and so on. On sodium iodide, I feel comfortable to go with a hard copy, because the decay is 230, and before it recovers, it goes to 900 nanoseconds. So the answer is advantage both economically and technologically. But what it justifies that is the volume. And I, you print the brochure, Kinkoscope is 10 cents, and then you print many of these. therefore the volume justifies that. And I think that I can get to a commercial version with the hard copy, of what is called hard copy of the FPGA. For sure I cannot do with the full programmable FPGA. That is for prototypes.
If we can, let's try to follow some plan on how we ask our specific questions. First on the list is the efficiency.
Yeah, that we should take the figure. Yeah, you suggested
we
that.
We need to go over this figure and see if anybody has any concerns about the. Let's see, there's a.
It's a two-page document. With the second page with your figure.
Anytime you claim that you're 400 times better than what's on the market, we better make sure that everybody knows why this claim is made. And this is the figure we can go from. Do we have questions on that? Everybody happy with the efficiencies that are listed here?
Let me describe a little more that figure. My starting point is, let me see if I find it here. It's an article by some people from General Electric. You can verify, since you got a calculator, you can verify my calculation here. Yeah. This is the article, Performance Characteristics of a Whole Body PET Scanner, Timothy DeGrado et al. And Edward Coleman, the Journal of Nuclear Medicine, Volume 35, Number 8, August 1994. So my 66 millicurie that I wrote at the top of the figure and 200,000 coincidence per section at the very bottom, I took those from this article. Could you help me and verify that? So it's this paragraph and this paragraph here. I extracted from those two paragraphs the rate, the data that they are collecting, the efficiency. And, then there is another article that is a standard NEMA, new standard for measurement in order to compare the performance of one detector compared to the other detector. Mm-hmm.